Mamaya mayroon tayong pinapaboran dito, bakit hindi tayo nagkakandak ng hearing. So, minabuti natin na mag-hearing kagad tayo kahit naka-break tayo. So, Mayor Janice, you have the floor.
Senator Bato, good morning, Mr. Chair. In line with what Senator Joel Villanueva have said and Senator J.V. Ejercito have said, allow me also to express, kami, the aggrieved party, also believe in your capacity to be fair and not to be biased in holding this Senate inquiry po. Siguro po yung pag-express ng mga taga Negros Oriental ng kanilang saloobin, tayo na nandito, nakikita po natin talaga kung ano yung totoong ginagawa natin dito. Kaya humihingi po kami ng pasensya on behalf of the people of Negros Oriental. Love po nila si Governor, kaya siguro pag medyo meron silang nakikitang mga bagay-bagay, they would express something like that. But kami po na aggrieved party, we are here. We are very appreciative po. Yung break nyo, ginamit nyo po para i-meet kami. Pinapili po ako ni Senator Bato ng time, kailan pwede. In fact, there was a schedule way earlier, pero sinabi ko po sa kanya, sa inyo po, na may nakaschedule na rin po kung po pwede ba na on this date po. Kaya I would like to put that on record that the victims, kami po na mga nandito, we are appreciative of the work that you do as a chairperson of the committee po, helping us to seek justice and legislative change for our province so that we will no longer see a violence and cruelty to proliferate in our province po. Salamat po, Senator Bato.
Thank you po, Mayor Ligamo, for that statement. Sincere na po kayo. I have to defend this committee against any malicious allegations. Ayoko madama yung mga kasamahan ko. Ako, personally na ako, okay lang, pero pag yung committee na ang pag-usapan, ibang usapan po yun. So I have to speak out. Thank you po for that understanding. And
kindly acknowledge once your name is called.
I have had enough violence in my life.
Good morning. Good morning, Mr. Chair.
Since day one of my career in the Philippine Constabulary, grabe ng violence dinaanan ko, kaya ngayong senador na ako, gusto ko sana tahimik na ang Pilipinas. Ayaw ko nang may tao pa na maghirap sa violence. Maniwala lang po kayo sa akin.
Thank you po.
Yes, ma'am.
In relation po to what we are about to do today, can I be allowed po to read my position paper?
Yes, ma'am. I will recognize you later after. Okay.
Sige po.
I will give you the floor.
Santiago,
later.
Executive Officer of the Anti-Organized Crime Division.
Good morning. If I may continue, today, we shall listen to the other witnesses and family members of those victims of other killings in Negros Oriental. However, given the number of resource persons, we shall limit their statements to the minimum sana para ma-accommodate natin lahat. Ha? Pero ayaw ko rin naman na ma-sacrifice yung quality ng output of this committee investigation affairs, kung mamadali natin masyado. Andito na kayo, pagbigyan namin kayo. Pero sana, go directly to the point tayo. Thank you. So from here, you want to deliver something, Mayor Digamo? Ma'am, yes, go ahead. You have the floor.
Good morning, Mr. Senate President, Mr. Chair, and the members of the committee. I think I will be joined by my colleague.
Sandali lang, Mayor. I was reminded by Comsec of the parliamentary procedures. First, we have to recognize all the resource persons around. At yung hindi pa nakapag under oath, ipa-out natin. Comsec, you have the floor.
Next, our applicant for naturalization, Mr. Kyle Jennerman.
Thank you, sir. We would like to recognize the presence of the following. From the Philippine National Police, we have Police Major General John L. Estomo.
Good morning, Senate President, Mr. Chair.
Police Brigadier General Sidney Villaflor.
I'm Attorney Charles representing.
Police Brigadier General Raul Bargamento.
From the National Commission of Senior Citizens, we have Attorney Franklin Quijano.
From the Armed Forces of the Philippines, we have Brigadier General Leonardo Peña.
From the
National Bureau of Investigation, we have Deputy Director for Operations, Attorney Jose Justo Yap.
Also from the
we National also have, we have Mr. Mayor Janice Degamo, Mayor Fritz Diaz.
That is all, Your Honor. Thank you very much.
We have some of the guest witnesses, sir. Ms. Montserrat Tabaku.
Take advantage, President.
Mr. Sherwin Lee Bianco. Ms. Gina Palma, sorry. And we'll be mentioning the other guest later when they will be called to appear, sir.
Virtual resource persons attending committee hearings. Since the pandemic is almost...
We also have former Governor of Negros Oriental, Honorable Henry Temes. And the other guests will be called later, sir, when they will have the time to deliver their messages, sir. That's all, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Chair, inquiry.
Yes, go ahead.
Wala si, ano, no, si Gerald Karamat, si IDG head, and also sa Region 7, anybody from Region 7, because we will have other questions later and issues. Somebody from the regional office or provincial office at least has to be here. Diba? Tsaka si Gerald Karamat of Intelligence. Kasi meron akong yaano mamaya. I would want to point out something, Mr. Chair, because of intelligence, because as part of our oversight function, siyempre, kayo humihingi, kami nagdedepensa rito ni Senator Bato ng pondo ng PNP, and I have done that. Nung chief PNP pa si Chief Bato, alam po niya that we have supported. But we want also to see how they are spending the intelligence fund. No, kasi kahapon, mayroong statement si Secretary Abalos that there was really failure of intelligence, which was contradicted by Gerald Karamat. Pero yung pala, Senator Bato, Mr. Chairman, meron ng admission ng PNP that there was already initial reports of these attempts on the life of Governor Degamo, and at marami na rin po nangyari ng mga assassination and killings. So, mamaya tatanong, gusto ko malaman sa PNP, what actions have they taken? Kasi nakakalungkot dito, alam na pala nilang metre. Meron public, siguro si Mayor Janice, tanungin ko na lang muna, Mr. Chair, with your indulgence, were there threats already to the life of Governor Degamo before this fatal assassination that took place? Meron na bang mga threats sa
buhay
niya?
Yes po, meron po.
Ano pong mga threats to? Sa text, sa publicly, ano pong klaseng threats?
I think he was able to get their report from the intelligence community po. In fact, I was able to get a video of us on our way to the mag-o-oath sana si Governor to return to his seat as Governor of Negros Oriental. When he mentioned their names, he mentioned there Mayor Henry and Congressman Arnie to be the source of threats of his life. Nasa video po yan, baka pwede natin ipakita din later.
Can you provide this committee yung video niyan para ma-play natin?
Yes, later po. Okay, paano po?
Please, the Senate President himself is here. Pa-ready lang, anytime, ipa-play natin.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you. Since this is a Senate hearing, all those...
Senator JB, if I may...
Mr. Chair, go ahead.
Kuha muna natin, ipatik-out muna natin yung mga bagong resource persons before we start.
May we request the new guests to please take their own. Hindi, okay na po kayo. Sina Mayor Diaz lang po, si General Peña, si Attorney Yap, si General Villaflor po. Please raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this investigation?
Majority
Thank you very much. Please take seats.
Yeah, before I yield the floor again to Senator JB, I would like to advise the PNP. Pwede ba ninyong i-present dito yung former regional director, former provincial director? Dahil lahat ng issues dito, hindi maisagot ng current PD, current RD. Dapat nandito sila para masagot nila. Will you require them to be here? Tawagan niyo. Kung nasa malayo, may enough time pa siya bumiyahe. Hanggang alas 5 pa tayo mamayang hapon. Pabihayin na niyo. Former RD, former PD, at yung former chief of police ng Bayawan City, yung umayaw ng blatter. At saka yung, kung meron pa yung supply officer, na may custody nung armas na na-recover as a instrument of that killing.
Sir, I agree. No? Tama, hindi mo makakasagot yung mga current regional and provincial director because this happened. Sila po may alam and I would like to ask them. No, meron na po lang initial reports, intelligence reports. Anong ginawa po nila? This shouldn't have happened. Diba? They should have augmented the security of Governor Degamo given the assassination threats on his person. Eh nakakapagtaka on that fateful day, nagtataka na nga ako, parang too much of a coincidence, bakit iisa lang nag-report, talagang walang kalaban-laban. Nakita niyo naman na Mr. Chairman, pagpasok, halos walang wala man lang nakabutok.
No resistance.
No resistance at all. So, meron talagang failure dito. And sana, wag naman isipin ng PNP na sila po sinisisi natin. But that is part of our oversight function. Ito po, nasa harapan nyo si Senator Bato de la Rosa, dating yung chief PNP. And ako po, I was the one who defended the budget of the PNP for several years. We have supported the PNP in terms of equipment, vehicles, lahat po. No, pinakamarami. Siguro, you can attest, Senator Bato, noong time natin, na time na nag-depend tayo, doon pinakamaraming kagamitan na bili ang PNP when I was defending PNP. Kaya lang, nakakasakit ang loob. Intelligence fund, almost 800 million. Sa AFP, 1.5 billion. Paano ito ginagamit? Saan ginagamit yung Intel fund? Diba? If there was already initial reports of that assassination attempt, bakit walang ginawa yung region at yung provincial office? And I hope I can go back later no, pag nandito na yung mga former regional police officer, police director, and provincial director. Eh, nakakalungkot, Mr. Chairman, akala ko sa customs, sa Bureau Immigration, yung pag may pinapainom yung mga patron, lumalabo ang mata. Ha? May pampabulag, may pampalabo. Ito, may pampabingi pa. Eh, imposible, hindi mo marinig ang 5.56. Madidistinguish siya ng mga shooter at mga militar at polis. Iba po yung tunog pag nagpa-practice. Ang 45, 9mm at yung 5.56. Mr. Chair, mukhang may inim na pampabingi ang mga polis doon. That's why I hope, Gerald Stomo, please ask the former regional police director and the provincial police director to be here.
Chief of Police.
And the Chief of Police of Bayawan.